Hi, in this video we will explore the functionality of exporting project standards. This button you will find in model categories, annotate categories, elements, schedules, and it's missing just in the spatial tab. So in these four tabs you will find this. No matter which button you use, it's exactly the same output that you will get. What is the idea behind it? Let's think about stripping down information from object styles, project information, list of your families in the model, and so on. So better to demonstrate than trying to explain it this way. Let's export project standards. And in this dialog box, what you will see, first of all, you can open Excel file after export, check by default, that is fine. Project information, object styles, line styles, and families. Let's export all and let's open the schedule to see. Let's call it sample model and let's say standards. Okay. So let's inspect these. Okay. What we can use, what we can see here is model information card in which we can tell that author is, for example, DiRoots LTD. As an example, then we can see model objects, and this becomes very interesting here. Let me zoom out a bit. You see this list is very big. In a nutshell, information that you see here, look how it's laid down. Category, then sub-items of the category or subcategories that you can find in object styles. And you will see the line weight or in projection, in cut, where is applicable, you will see the number. Where is not applicable, you will not see the number. Okay, and line color RGB. Notice that this color here is equivalent of the RGB values that you will find on the left side. So in this way, you can just easily scroll down and see, for example, I'm looking for the blue color. It's very easy to find what is the blue color, or of course, in the other way, you can just find here in the list. 0, 0, 255, right? Let's see what other information we have. Annotation objects. We see for the annotation objects such as conduit fitting tags, conduit tags, and so on. You can change the line weight and the color. You see the representation of the color. Okay. Analytical model categories. Okay. Imported categories. Here we have some DWG file that is important, roofing DWG, okay. These are the overrides. Good. Line styles. We have different line styles. We can influence these line styles from the Excel template itself. It's very easy to keep everything consistent in graphical sense. And what we can see also is the families. In this way, you can see the list of the families that is inside your model. And types under the specific families. For example, BS Universal Beam, we have these types under this. Okay. So let's do some changes. We put here that author is DiRoots LTD. Of course, it's not. Small disclaimer, right? But what we can do, for example, let's find the walls. Okay. Walls are on the bottom. Or we can simply type walls. Find next, and we find the walls. Let's, for some reason, just to emphasize the effect that we will do, let's put that line thickness is 8. Let's put on all wall-related subcategories or sub-elements. And let's see, this is applied here. Let's apply it also here. In projection and the cut, and let's say that was just for ease of our visualizing, let's say it's a red, fully red color, 100% red color, okay? So what we can do, we can drag this color. If I click save, and I come back here, and I click preview import, and let's see sample model standards, Excel file. If we scroll down a bit, we will see that we updated walls. Okay, you will see this color, so it means that we updated walls. Update the model. give it a second to propagate the changes. And even now, you can easily see that walls are now colored with a red color. If I turn off thin lines, you will see the very, very thick red color, which looks, by the way, ugly, but just for sake of demo, this is what you can control from the Excel file itself. And let's go to manage project information and see, is DiRoots listed here as an author? Yes. So, hope you get the idea what you can do with Expo project standards. It's a really nice tool to try to organize standardized workflow and visual styles in Revit. And the best part, this template, once created from the model that contains all of these categories, can be applied to other models, not just this one. Okay. Thank you, and see you in next video.